Welcome to the Master Cars Pro channel. Today we'll talk about the problems and weaknesses of Volvo V60. Those who fondly remember the large and square-sided Volvo estates of yesteryear, rammed full of children, dogs, antique furniture and Wellington boots, will no doubt be quite surprised by the Swedish firm's modern-day wagons. Gone is that utilitarian approach, and in its place now is a series of lifestyle estates, good-looking swish and SUV, aimed very much at families whose idea of getting dirty is spilling a Starbucks coffee on their holstered hoodie rather than digging up their garden or mucking out a big stee. The V60's shape is undoubtedly pleasing to the eye, and the grille is unmistakably that of a Volvo. Underneath is actually an old enough car to borrow lots of its underpinnings from Ford. The V60, dating from an era where the American company had a large stake in Volvo cars. Under the bonnet, the V60 offered a huge range of engines over the years. Petrol-wise, there was a 1.6-liter 150 bhp T3 and a 1.6-liter 180 bhp T4 that was replaced in 2017 by a 188 bhp 2.0-liter engine, 240 bhp 2.0-liter, known as the T5, and a 304 bhp 3-liter unit known as the T6. There's a 115 bhp 1.6-liter diesel T2 replaced in 2016 with a 118 bhp 2-liter engine, and two further diesel options based on the same 2.0-liter diesel engine with either 136 or 148 bhp D3 or 163, 179 or 187 bhp D4. There is also a 2.4-liter diesel that powered the range, topping 212 bhp D5 and 289 bhp plug-in hybrid diesel D6 model. The fastest V60 was the 364 2 bhp powerhouse polisher that rounded out the range. Five trim levels were available over the years: business edition, SE, NAV, SE looks NAV, art design NAV, and art design looks NAV, as well as there was a later ES trim. While there were two trims for the rushed V60 cross-country, a raised-up version with some additional bodywork for occasional off-road use. On the road, the V60 is an able performer with most of its engine options, although the 1.6 diesels can feel sluggish. None of the diesels are particularly refined either, although their on paper economy is much better than the petrol options offer. Most examples come equipped with a 6-speed manual gearbox, a standard, though the automatic gearbox was a popular alternative in many versions. Approach a corner and you'll find the V60 competent but uninspiring. There's plenty of grip, but its steering is a little slow and its handling is perhaps compromised by a chassis setup that's definitely biased towards ride comfort. On broken surfaces and beaten up road irregularities, the V60 rides with an almost old-fashioned panache, and its comfort will be appreciated by those who don't deal with every corner as though it was the last one at LE Mans. By the standards of the times in which the V60 was launched in 2010, the interior is stylish and quite imaginative. The seats are comfortable and the driving position good. The floating center console looks a little old-fashioned now, and there are rather too many buttons gathered around it. Space-wise, it's good up front, but for in the rear, leggy teenagers won't like traveling behind a taller driver, and the boot is surprisingly short of room. A corollary of that extravagant and stylish rear roofline, with its new lifestyle agenda, the V60 will have been used on school runs and family holidays and for shopping in tight city center car parks. so check the bodywork carefully for scuffs and dents, and the alloy wheels, if fitted, for any curb damage. Check the operation of the rear tailgate and that the rear seats drop easily. The automatic gearbox requires new fluid every 3 years, so check paperwork to make sure this has been carried out. And the whole, the V60 has a good reputation for reliability. Early diesel engine cars could have problems with diesel particulate filters clogging, but this was often remedied with a good long drive. Clones have also been reported at low revs. In the diesels, although this hasn't necessarily led to the car breaking down, problems were also reported with the EGRs of certain D4 engine cars, leading to the check engine light coming on and the car occasionally going into limp home mode. Volvo is presently in the process of recalling around 70,000 cars in the UK fitted with 2.0 liter diesel engine. Over potential engine fires, there isn't a fix at the moment, so owners are being told to pay attention to any unusual smells coming into the interior. If the engine warning light illuminates, or if the engine hesitates under acceleration, the fuel hose used in some models has been found to be cracked up from the inside, which could lead to a fuel leak if not fixed. This applies to cars built between April 11, 2015 and March 30, 2016, and a Volvo dealer will be able to tell you if your car is affected or not. There have been a few recalls regarding airbags that might not deploy correctly during a collision. The first is for the driver's airbag on V60. It's made between May 9, 2016 and May 22, 2016. While the second effects example is built between August 30, 2016 and October 21st, 2016, contact your local Volvo dealer to make sure your car has had the relevant remedial work carried out. It's been identified that there could be a coolant leak during the warm-up process of some V60s built between 1st July 2010 and 20th April 2015 that could result in an engine fire in extreme circumstances. Check with the Volvo dealer to make sure your car isn't affected by this. A problem was found with the vehicle connectivity module VCM that sends location information to the emergency services after a collision. It applies to cars constructed between 13 December 2017 and 30 October 2018. Any Volvo dealer should be able to perform a software update to fix the issue. On some examples built between 2 December 2010 and 2 February 2015 that have a manual gearbox and start-stop technology fitted with the parking brake may release without warning. This happens with the engine on and when the gear lever is moved, so it shouldn't occur when the car is left unattended. Any Volvo dealer will be able to tell if your car is affected on. Apply the updated software required to prevent this from happening if required. A vacuum line got a brake booster could chafe on the wiper mechanism of some cars, which could result in a loss of vacuum pressure and increased pedal effort to slow the car down. Your Volvo dealer will be able to identify affected cars, fix the issue for your free of charge. A trim panel may work loose when the curtain airbag deploys in the event of a collision on a smaller number of V60s built between the built for the 2013 model year. Speak to your local Volvo dealer to find out if your car is affected or if it all has already had the remedial work carried out. A software update is currently being started to correct an issue with the fuel gauge showing the wrong level on the vehicles constructed between 21st May 2014 and 11 December 2015. The current advice if your car is affected is to keep at the level about a third of a tank to ensure you don't run out of the fuel and until a fix can be implemented. The front seat belt of example made between 15 September 2015 and 19 August 2015 may not protect occupants correctly in the event of a collision, and you'll need to replace with modified parts, a Volvo dealer will be able to tell you if your car is affected or and if it still needs this recall to be carried out. Some V60s made between 25 September 2018 and 1st April 2019 could have a problem with the rear suspension links because they weren't correctly tightened at the factory. Speak with the Volvo dealer to find out further information as to whether your car is affected by this recall. Certain examples we did with a five-cylinder engine had a problem with the high pressure fuel lines not being installed correctly, which could cause a leak and a potential fire. Contact your local dealer for further information as to whether your car is affected. A possible software issue on V60s built between 21st January 2015 and 18 February 2016 could cause electrical problems and the power steering system to stop working. There also have been other issues, including the auxiliary drive belt that powers the power steering pump can fail and affect the power steering system, and power steering return line that can leak fluid. If it gets too low, steering assistance will be reduced. This generation of V60 has done rather well. In our most recent reliability survey, managing to secure a third place finish in the executive car class that consisted of 22 models, Volvo as a brand finished in 11th place out of 31 manufacturers in the same survey. You've got a good choice of engines on the US market, but we'd try and seek out one of the D4 diesels because it has a good combination of power and economy. ES Trim was a later addition to the range and came sufficiently well equipped, though we would look for one that comes with a sat-nav standard, the so-called ES nav model. The Audi A Avant is the state version of one of our favorite executive cars. It's available with a range of punchy and efficient engines, both petrol and diesels, and it's impressively refined with nearly all of them. Its interior is a highly quality, beautifully designed delight with an excellent infotainment system. It's also efficient in all guises. The BMW 3 Series Touring adds a dose of practicality to the impact executive car that defined its own class. The 3 Series Saloon, that boot is of useful size and shape, and the rest of the car retains all the virtues that have made the Beamer so popular. It's great to drive, has strong performance and excellent infotainment system called iDrive. Well, if you are the owner of this car, then please describe the problems that you had to face during the operation of the car. Perhaps it is your feedback that'll help viewers when choosing a car. That's it for today. Thanks everyone for attention. It isn't much work for you to subscribe to the channel. See you soon.